Good morning. So, Snippet Pixie dev. We're in the middle of converting some Vala code for passing a date placeholder into Go code. Of placeholders that you can put in date with a calculation and a format. And it'll expand when you insert the snippet into your text. So what we're going to do, so we're at the point of trying to work out basically how to create this range. So I think we're going to try this index any that I found just at the end of the last video. So that'll be interesting, actually, how that works. Let's find actually, I don't need to do that. I'm just going to say I'm going to find the documentation for that, but I'm going to just try here. So what we'll do is we will take that, because that's the limiters I want to use. So what I might, at this point, I should have yeah, so this is the interesting bit. We should have maybe some sort of calculation string. So that could be something like plus 1y plus 2m or something to get to add a year and 2 months. And we should have some sort of date format. If it wasn't specified, it's going to default to either X or one of the X's, depending on the macro, whether it's date or time. So we've got in this calc variable, we've got something, hopefully, maybe. We don't know for sure. I haven't stepped through this yet, so we'll see when we actually start debugging, because it's bound to need this debugging, whether it's going to work or not. But we're going to have this kind of string that we need to split into number plus operator as such. So I think we'll have a go at this indexy thing. So I'm going to comment that out. Just keep it for reference for the moment. So we are hoping, I don't know what this index any does. So let's see. So it's going to be something like strings dot index any. It returns an int. Okay. That's right. It's not splitting it. It's not a split in it, is it? No. All right. So that's right. Okay, so we've got to do something a bit different here. We need to loop over this. So So we need a while loop, which I don't think I've ever done one of them and go yet. Yeah, all right, let's try this. So let's go to the docks. Where's the tour guy usually has good index onto things. Oh, okay. So I can use 4. Okay. So in that case, I could do an initial check for the index. Have one. I'm going to go into the 4. Okay. So what I could probably do then is something like yeah, see, this is the thing. I'm going to be going through this instead, I think. Whereas, I kind of want to do a little spike test here. I don't know if I can do that in here. Oh, no. So what I want to do here is I'm going to have calc. It's going to be equal to some sort of string. So let's say plus one y. Plus 2m, and I'm going to there's different ways, I think. Can I split that? Let's try this, see what we get. Format. Oops. Doesn't do autocomplete or anything, does it? Print line. Runes. Is that going to work? Cool. Okay. So we're going to get. Let's get rid of that. That's a little distracting. Right. So I can split this up into its component parts, and then I could loop over the components. And if I know the position, so if I can do also. So if probably before that, I can do something like, what was I going to call it? So I can just copy and paste in a minute. Nums. So I should be able to do something like, well, do pause. Pause is equal to strings dot split. Nope. Index any. On the calc. I need that to be in that. And take that. I'm just going to print that out. See what we've got. We should get the first one, which is 1012. 2. Cool. Okay. So in that case, num num, it's going to be well, I can do different things here, can I? I can do could loop over. Check each individual bit and make sure it's numeric. Well, plus minus or numeric. Or I could just pluck it out and use it. I wonder if I've got the equivalent of a pass, because that would help. Let's try something. So what we'll do is we will take I'm going to take we'll take runes, we'll take everything up to but excluding the position that we've just calculated. That's the number. So that should be plus one. Oh. No. Okay. And then I could do strings join. So let's put it back. That would work. Then all I need to do is go through them. Make sure I've got that number there. We'll already have the position. So we can get the unit. Among the calc to get rid of. Everything before that position. B. Based on the unit, do the calculation with the num. Yeah, okay. Let's grab what I just did there. We'll stick that there for the moment, but that's not where it's going to stay. So we're going to get. I want to call it runes. It's not quite right. Let's call it. Calc parts. Don't need to print it. So, don't need to print it. What does index return if it doesn't find -1? And so if parse is less than, well, it's 1, that's the issue there. If it's less than 1, then there's no number either. I mean, technically I should put 2 there, because we really should have +1 at the minimum. I really want to have a plus or minus, but I can get away with that, I think. here. I'm not going to do these warnings because that turned out to be a bit of a mess. Does not seem to have a positive or negative in placeholder. This is just going to be a comment to myself now. Does not seem to have a number. Before it in placeholder. Now I'll do. Okay, so we'll bump out there. Although we don't really need to do that. So what we can do is we can go so for a while pause is what we could do. Well, pause is greater than zero. Because at some point it's going to do minus one. Yeah. Because we're going to start trimming it off. This will probably be moved in a minute. I'm not going to do the count stuff. Don't know. Don't think we need that, whatever that was. Now we need to do this. Going to make it a lot easier. Actually, I'm going to move that. It's not quite right, is it? Took it out for the moment. So, okay, let's assume we found a position, say, 2. Come in, position is greater than 0. Good. Come down, we do num is calc parts up until 2. So that's going to be 0 and 1 part, segments into num joined together. So we've basically got a number, which is going to be maybe plus 1 or minus 1 or something like that. I need to do this position stuff. Doing that already. So the unit. So the unit is going to be what we just created. So that's going to be calculation parts. Position. And then so that's substringing that effectively. Case statements. I guess I can do a strings join there just to. Clean it up. Right, new date. Is that set? Is that date there? So this could be interesting. Can I do negatives there? Does an add with a negative number, does that work? And I want to cast it to an int. So and I probably need to, I do probably need to get the error for that as well. So let's check that. So pass string to num. Not been there before. Do I do string conf? Right, well, we only want to deal with integers because we're talking days, hours, minutes, seconds. You have to do that. I'm not doing decimals. So that could have been interesting, actually. Anyway, I'm going to do basically this. Format scan. I think that's all I need. So this is scam. I have to find out what that thing is because apparently stick that into the address of num. If it's not here, got to nail. We need to bail. Now, have I done any of that yet? Or not. Okay, I'm just going to return the string. This is going to be like Any problem? Bail. And why? Okay, so why is that not? SS. Oh. No, that's right. S. Can I go format on here? Oh, clash. Okay, all right. That's a problem. That's why. Okay. How often am I using it? Lots. Okay, but I need to change it. Let's make it more useful. Hold on. Okay. Only looking for the first one anyway, so hopefully that's okay. We'll see. Okay, so that'd be interesting to see if that works. So we'll get the unit and then I'm going to add a date interval, so what did you want to do here? Is duration time dot duration, and then down here we want to do duration equals I need to look up timey stuff. Don't know how to do it. Okay. So I don't need to do anything, any of that parsing that I've just done. Because there's a function for it. Okay, let's try that. That's nuts, isn't right, so duration is equal to, hold on. Yep. Time dot pass duration. So if I just converted everything, I bet it'd work. Let's try. Well, it's not going to understand. Plus one y plus two m. Is it? And does it know handling? Yes. Actually, print it out, right? So I can see it. 0 seconds, all right, so that's not right. So what if I do, what's that? Where's the thingies then? Oh, there is no Y. All right, so I can't really use that. I'd have to pass out the Y, do the. Yeah, that's not what I want. Okay. It's a bit of a pain actually because a year. It's not necessarily 24 hours times 365. So wonder. That might be problematic. is going to be interesting. So right, okay. I'm going to have to do it in two parts. I can use add date. And then add the time as a duration. So duration really only does actual time rather than days, months, years. So I'm going to have to do it in two different sections as such. All right, they have to be careful here. Years, months, days. And then I'm gonna have to look up weeks in a minute as well. So we'll just do week as a 7-day. Okay. But I have to be very quick now because I'm running out of time. So I'm not going to do that anymore. I'm not going to do the duration thing. Think. Well, here we're going to do new day again. So new date is equal to new date add date none 0 months and 0 days. Months, we switch that up a bit. And for days, we switch it again. For weeks, well, I guess. It's the same as days. Times 7. We'll see if that works actually, because it might have different meaning. Okay, so if we're doing an hour. I'm going to be doing add, and then the duration. And that duration has to be set. So the duration is equal to time dot Yeah, I'm looking in the wrong place, aren't I? Let's look in the docs for a sec. Okay, don't even need to do that. So I can actually just do add and then multiply up. I'm doing 10 days there. Because we don't have anything other than our. Okay. Alright, so duration is gone. Don't need that. So it's time dot hour times num. Why is it complaining? In 64, by the looks of things, is that right? Why is it the constants? Don't have the time. Don't have the Because of duration. Fine, but duration. Oh, okay, duration is in 64. Okay. Right. Nice. That's a bit of a pain, but. Because. Well, that's fine actually. I can do that. Okay, now I've got. Right, I don't really want to do any calculations in 64 space anyway. So what we'll do here is we'll just switch these ones in 64 a little bit, and let's see for how many years and stuff. Why is that complaining? What? Right, I'm out of time as well. Gotta go. Why on earth? I'm gonna have to stop now, I've gotta go. But I'm gonna have to look at that, so how? I'll do. Well, we're getting there, I think. We've kind of worked out some strategy, I think. We're going to come through. We hopefully have the units and positions, and we're just going to start adding them to the date, this new date. And then we'll be able to do the formatting stuff in a minute. But not today, because I've got to go. So thanks for watching. Until next time, take care.